بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم، الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين محمد بن عبد الله النبي الصادق الأمين، وعلى آله وصحبه الطيبين الطاهرين ومن تبعهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين، اللهم آمين. Tonight we will have the eighth session about the infallibility of the prophets, and specifically tonight we will start talking about Prophet Sulaiman عليه السلام. This is the first session about Sulaiman. We need, I think, three sessions about him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We talked about the Isma frame, we talked about the Isma of Adam, Ibrahim, and Yusuf in the past. And tonight we'll talk about the Isma of Sulaiman. We are going to address three issues. This week, we will talk about a question: did he teach people magic? Next week, we will talk about And another question, did he prefer horses over the remembrance of Allah? And the third week, we'll talk about Ayah 34, the fitna Sulaiman alayhi salam went through, and understand all of this within the concept of the Isma. So tonight, we'll talk about Prophet Sulaiman and magic. The Ayah, Surah Al-Baqarah 102, واتبعوا ما تتلو الشياطين على ملك سليمان وما كفر سليمان ولكن الشياطين كفروا يعلمون الناس السحر وما أنزل على الملكين ببابل هاروت وماروت وما يعلمان من أحد حتى يقولا إنما نحن فتنة فلا تكفر فيتعلمون منهما ما يفرقون به بين المرء وزوجه وما هم بضارين به من أحد إلا بإذن الله ويتعلمون ما يضرهم ولا ينفعهم ولقد علموا لمن اشتراه ما له في الآخرة من خلاق ولبئس ما شروا به أنفسهم لو كانوا يعلمون صدق الله العظيم. There are many translations. All of them are the same. One example is Sahih International. And they followed instead about the Jild of Israel what the devils had recited during the region of Sulaiman, Solomon or Sulaiman. It was not Solomon who disbelieved, but the devils disbelieved, teaching people magic and that which was revealed to the two angels at Babylon, Harut and Marut. But they, the two angels, don't teach anyone unless they say, we are a trial. So don't disbelieve. And yet they learn from them that by which they cause separation between a man and his wife. But they don't harm anyone through it except by the permission of Allah. And they, people, learn what harms them and does not benefit them. But they, in reference to children of Israel, certainly knew that whoever purchased it, the magic, wouldn't have in the hereafter any share, any good share. And wretched is that for which they sold themselves, if they only knew. This similarly is Uthmani, Taqi Uthmani translation, Abd al-Halim translation, very much the same concept. So followed what the evil ones had fabricated about the kingdom of Sulaiman or during his domain, and instead, not that Sulaiman himself was a disbeliever, it was the evil ones who were disbelievers. They taught people, this is the point, magic or witchcraft or sorcery, and that which was revealed in Babylon to the two angels, Harut and Marut. This is the point which we will talk about. So, I highlighted this portion in blue. واتبعوا ما تتلو الشياطين على ملك سليمان وما كفروا سليمان ولكن الشياطين كفروا يعلمون الناس السحر. Now this ayah is very clear. In number one, Sulaiman did not practice magic. And of course he was not, astaghfirullah, a disbeliever. He was a prophet. So the ayah is clear on this. But also it is clear on another issue that Satan's did teach people magic. ولكن الشياطين كفروا يعلمون الناس السحر. It was the evil ones who disbelieved. They taught people magic. They, in reference to the shayateen. Okay. So those two, the ayah is very clear about. Sulaiman did not practice magic, didn't promote magic, didn't commit astaghfirullah kufr, and the shayateen taught people magic. So this part is agreed upon in the ayah about the, among the scholars and the mufassirin. The debate was about the following four points. Okay, did the angels also teach magic or not? The first part, okay, yeah, the shayateen did teach magic. But are they alone or did angels also teach magic? And how about Harut and Marut? Are they angels or not? And what did the devils teach? Did they teach magic and something else or what? And what do we mean by the shayateen mentioned in the ayah, the devils? So the discussion will be about number two, actually, those debatable issues. Did angels also teach magic? Were Harut and Marut angels? What did devils teach? And who are the devils mentioned in the ayah? Now, to talk about the angels, we need to build a frame. Always. You can't proceed in any discussion if you are not sharing the others the same frame. Unless if you are on the same page, there is no way to agree later on. So let's set the tone. Let's agree on the frame or the, on the page. Number one, Quran described angels being وَقَالُوا اتَّخَذَ الرَّحْمَنُ وَلَدًا سُبْحَانَهُ بَلْ عِبَادٌ مُكْرَمُونَ. He described them of being honored servants. They said, the Rahman has taken to himself a son, in reference to the angels, because they said, الْمَلَائِكَ بَنَاتُ اللَّهِ, and the banat is walad. كُلُّ مَوْلُودٍ walad. Any born is walad. Walad does not necessarily translate to boy. It can be mean boy and it can mean daughter, son and daughter. So they say the most compassionate Lord has taken to himself a son. Actually, the English translation walad shouldn't be translated to a son. Walad is a born baby. The exact meaning of the word walad is a born baby, an infant, who will tend to be one of his children. Boy or girl. Glory to him, Subhana, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala answers that. Bal ibadun mukramun, those whom they so designate as being the daughters of God are only his honored servants. So the malaika were not the children of God, they were not the daughters of God, and of course Isa alayhi salam was not the son of God. So, but here the point is about the angels. Bal ibadun mukramun. And only, they are only his honored servants. In another ayah, Al-Quran came describes them, لَا يَعْصُونَ اللَّهَ مَا أَمَرَهُمْ وَيَفْعَلُونَ مَا يُؤْمَرُونَ. The angels never disobey God's commands to them, and they do as they are ordered. Surah Al-Tahrim. So these two ayat are describing the angels of being honored, servants, never disobey what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala orders them to do. The other point is that Quran states that angels would never be sent to people. قُلْ لَوْ كَانَ فِي الْأَرْضِ مَلَائِكَةٌ يَمْشُونَ مُطْمَئِنِّينَ لَنَزَّلْنَا عَلَيْهِمْ مِنَ السَّمَاءِ مَلَكًا رَسُولًا. Say, had there been angels living on the earth, walking about in the earth in peace, we would have certainly sent down an angel from the heavens as a messenger. So God would not send angels as messengers. A person would ask, what about Jibreel? Jibreel was the ambassador, the connection between God to the messengers. So Jibril will communicate with the messenger only. And the messenger will communicate with people. So our messenger is Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, not Jibril. Jibril عليه السلام is the angel of revelation revealing the message to Muhammad. And Muhammad would convey it to people, not Jibril. A person would say, didn't Jibril come on one day in the shape of a human being and ask Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم questions? Well, it went through Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. He did not come directly to people to convey to them anything. Even in that episode, he was asking the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم. And Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم would answer them. It took form of question and answer, Q&A. And after he left, he asked them, do you know who is this person? They said, no. He said, هذا جبريل. This is Jibril came to teach you. But teaching you through me, through Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would not send angels as messengers to people at all, with any message. The other point, these ayat which we talk about are very clear. Then we should avoid Israeliyat. Reports came to us through the Israeliyat should be avoided. They have no value in the Islamic epistemology, in Islamic knowledge. Another point is that Islamic aqidah is not a blind faith, nor it is a dogma. It is consistent and has no contradiction. Islam didn't ask us to believe that prophets are infallible, but at the same time, we have to believe that they, astaghfirullah al-azim, committed zina. They are contradicting each other. Being infallible means he wouldn't commit any of these sins. So Islam would not tell us, oh, wait a minute, you have to believe that he is infallible, and you have to believe that he committed so and so and so. No, that's not part of the Islamic system of faith. Islamic aqidah has no blind faith. It's built on reason, and its evidences are very clear. The belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is rational. The belief in Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is rational. The belief in Quran itself is rational. And after believing in Quran, we believe in whatever is mentioned in Quran because Quran is based on reason. So anything came after that is based on Quran, which is based on reason. So it's not blind faith. It's not a dogma. And it is very consistent with no contradictions. Having established the frame and set the page, so let's move to answer these questions. The discussion is about, because the first part of the ayah says, it's very clear that they followed what was told by the Satans, and Sulaiman didn't commit kufr, but the Shayateen did commit kufr, teaching people magic. Until this, the end of the blue line is understood. Then the ayah continues, وَمَا أُنزِلَ عَلَى الْمَلَكَيْنِ بِبَابِلَ هَارُوتَ وَمَارُوتَ. All translations read the following. And they taught people magic, and they taught people what was revealed in the Pearlion to the angels Harut and Marut. So the Satans taught people magic and taught people what had been revealed to the angels. So what had been revealed to the angels, Harut and Marut, is also taught and propagated by the Satans. This is the meaning of this translation. Now, how to understand this ayah? We have two major views. I don't want to get into all details of how, but mainly speaking, two major views. The first group says the following, that there was a dialogue happened between Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the angels and the sins of people. So the angels told him, subhanahu wa ta'ala, look to people, how sinner they are. So he told them, if you go down, you'll do the same thing. So they designated, chose two people, two angels. Allah sent them down to the earth. And then in the earth, they committed all kinds of zina, killing, drinking wine. And after that, they want to return back to the heavens, but they forget the passcode, and thus they remained in the earth teaching people magic. Another people say, no, actually Allah sent the angels to teach magic. It's not because they went down to the earth and they did whatever was done, but Allah purposefully sent angels to people to teach magic and warn them about it. But all these views are based on the Israeliyat, as Ibn Kathir and others stated. Ibn Kathir did excellent job. He went over all of those reports and he traced back the Sanad and said all of them go back, reach us to Ka'b al-Ahbar. So Ka'b al-Ahbar means Israeliyat. Now, some people say, well, Ka'b al-Ahbar is trusted. The point is not whether he was trusted or not. The point is when Ka'b al-Ahbar relates these things, there are news from the people of the book. The content which he is reporting is Israeliyat. No matter how, whether he was just or not, the discussion is not about his adala, his justice. The discussion is about the contents which he is narrating. Now, this group says that ما وما أنزل على الملكين, those who know Arabic, they say it is a relative pronoun. So the Satans taught people magic and that which was revealed to the angels. So we understand now their logic. They say ما is relative pronoun. واو is conjunction letter. ما is relative pronoun. So شيطان, Satan's taught people magic and taught people what had been revealed to the angels in Babylon, namely Harut and Marut. The second group says, wait a minute, Harut and Marut are not angels. There are two humans taught magic. What to do with the letter ma? Ma? They say ma is a negative article. It's not a relative pronoun. Negative article للنفي. Ma النافية. So the ayah means that and it was not sent down to the angels. The magic was not sent down to the angels. So the first group says, Harut and Marut are angels. They are the ones who taught people magic. How? Like we said, two scenarios. One scenario says that there was a dialogue between Allah and the angels ask Allah, look to people, what do they do? So he told them, if you go down, we'll do more. So they chose two angels and so on. So our second scenario, Allah purposefully sent angels to people in the earth to teach people magic and to warn them. Second group says, no, ma is negative. And the ayah negates that it was revealed to the angels. What helps in understanding the ayah is the frame. Because this presents angels as sinners, whether they were sent based on the episode or based on another scenario. And the other language tools, the conjunction letter, wa and ma. ولكن الشياطين كفروا يعلمون الناس السحر وما أنزل على الملكين. If we consider wa as conjunction letter and we consider ma as relative pronoun based on the first group, it means that the devils should have taught people two things, magic plus what was sent to the angels. يعلمون الناس السحر, teaching people magic, and what was revealed. So magic plus. Now, in Arabic, العطف يقتضي المغايرة. Conjunction means distinction. If you are saying Ali and Ahmed came, it means Ali and Ahmed came. Ali and Ahmed are two people, are not one. إن الله يأمر بالصلاة والصيام. Allah orders us to fast, to pray and fast. They are not the same. إن الصفا والمروة من شعائر الله. صفا and مروة are two rites from Allah. So the صفا is different than the مروة. ويقومون الصلاة ويؤتون الزكاة. Establish the prayer and perform, pay the zakah. They are different. Conjunction means distinction between two items. So, based on this, what was that thing which was revealed to the angels and the shayateen taught it? You cannot say it's magic because magic is in the beginning. The Satan taught people magic plus what was revealed. So what is that thing which was revealed to the angels? So to know what is the second item that the Satan taught people. So the first group does not answer all of these questions. But they keep saying, no, it just happened because it's fitna. But even this cannot answer the ayah. وَمَا نُرْسِلُ الْمُرْسَلِينَ إِلَّا مُبَشِّرِينَ وَمُنْذِرِينَ. We don't send the messengers, but as bearers of good tidings and as warners. The prophets were not sent as fitna. They are sent to guide us, to show us the right path. So to say that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent the angels to teach people magic as fitna, it goes against all of this. And it goes against the fact that Allah would not send angels as messengers to people. Now, the other view, this other view, which is we say that ma is negative, this is the view of Al-Qurtubi. Al-Qurtubi did excellent job. He used two linguistic tools. Number one, saying ma is negative article, like we said. So it was not revealed. Second point, he used the rhetoric tool, which is taqdim and ta'khir. Look to those, the first line in Arabic is the ayah, and I underlined a statement. So Al-Qurtubi says, let's have that underlined statement, move it forward to read the following. We cannot recite the second line. The ayah is the first line. But the meaning, Al-Qurtubi says, thus the meaning becomes, وَلَكِنَّ الشَّيَاطِينَ بِبَابِلَ هَارُوتَ وَمَارُوتَ كَفَرُوا يُعَلِّمُونَ النَّاسَ السِّحْرِ. But the Satans in Babylon, Harut and Marut, committed disbelief. They taught people magic. Period. وَمَا أُنزِلَ عَلَى الْمَلَكَيْنِ. And it was not revealed to the angels. Okay, so it was the evils in Babylon, Harut and Marut, who were disbelievers. They taught people witchcraft or magic or sorcery. Period. And that was not revealed to the angels. Tabari quoted both views, and he really explained what later on Al-Qurtubi took very well. But he did not adopt it. He went back and he said, no, Harut and Marut angels and the other ones who taught magic. Ibn Kathir agrees with the Qurtubi view. And then after explaining it, he talked about Tabari. He said a very profound statement, very amazing statement, Ibn Kathir said. He said, ثم شرع ابن جرير في رد هذا القول. And then Ibn Jarir al-Tabari, he started after explaining this view that ma is a negative article and that taqdim and ta'khir, we have moved this part forward to mean the second line. He said, After that, Ibn Jarir or Tabari started dismantling that understanding. And that ma, he insists that it means relative pronoun. وأطال القول في ذلك. And he talked lengthily about it. وادعى, and he claimed that Harut and Marut are malakan, two angels. أنزلهم الله إلى الأرض. Allah sent them down to the earth. وأذن لهما في تعليم السحر. And he permitted them, he gave them permission to teach people magic. اختبارا لعباده وامتحانا. As a test for his servants. ثم, and then he بين لعباده أن ذلك مما ينهى عنه. And then after that, he explained to his people that this magic is something condemned by the messengers. وادعى ابن كثير continues that ابن جرير claimed أن هاروت وماروت مطيعان, that هاروت and ماروت were actually obedient في تعليم ذلك, in teaching this, because لأنهما امتثلا ما أمر به, because they compiled with whatever Allah سبحانه وتعالى ordered them with. وهذا الذي سلكه غريب جدا. And this route which Ibn Jarir took is very strange. So Ibn al-Qurtubi like again, let's explain it again. He says ما is negative article, and that بباب الهاروت وماروت, this phrase should be moved in the meaning, not in the recitation, to the beginning of the ayah. So the ayah will read in the meaning, it was the evils in Babylon, Harut and Marut, who were disbelievers. They taught people witchcraft, magic, sorcery, period. And that magic or witchcraft was not revealed to the angels. Al-Tabari quoted this even before Al-Qurtubi, because we know Al-Qurtubi came after Al-Tabari. So he brought up, he explained it, and then he started dismantling it. Ibn Kathir quoted al-Tabari and he said, this is what al-Tabari did. He brought this view and he started refuting it, claiming that the Harut and Marut were obedient because they obeyed Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in whatever they are ordered with. They executed exactly what they were ordered with. And he says, surprised from الطبري وهذا الذي سلكه غريب جدا. And this which route, this route which الطبري took is very strange. How can you say this, all of what you said, and then went to this, go to this, reach this conclusion? Ibn Ashur too also adopted Qurtubi's view. He says all of those reports are from the Israeliyat, which is true. Now, who are the Satans mentioned in the ayah? First of all, the Satan can be a proper noun to the Shaitan, Iblis, and can mean people. وَكَذَٰلِكَ جَعَلْنَا لِكُلِّ نَبِيٍ عَدُوًا شَيَاطِينَ الْإِنسِ وَالْجِنِّ يُوحِي بَعْضُهُمْ إِلَى بَعْضٍ زُخْرُفَ الْقَوْلِ غُرُورًا. And so it is that against every prophet, we have set up the evil ones from among men and jinn, shayateen from men and jinn. So if the shaitan from the jinn is shaitan, proper noun. If the shaitan from the ins, he's also shaitan. Some of them inspire others with specious speech only by the way of delusion. So based on this, Harut and Marut were humans, satans in the shape of human beings. And they lived in Babylon, and they taught people magic. And which magic, according to the ayah, it's the black magic. They used to break down the family. So, Sulaiman, to conclude, Sulaiman did not teach people magic at all. Angels did not teach magic too at all. This refutes the Israelite claim that angels taught magic. Actually, the Israelites, as Quran stated, took hostile position regarding Jibril and other angels, especially Jibril and Mikael. So they used to say those are the ones who taught us magic. And the one who taught magic, Harut and Marut, as it is very clear. Now, of course, there are some other issues related to this. Some of it we will discuss later on when we talk about the infallibility of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Was he ever influenced by magic or not? That will be talked about when we talk about Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam, because they are the ones who are promoting that magic has impact. They say even it has impact on the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But the ayat says it didn't. They don't have impact. Look to the ayah. What does it say? The ayah says, فَيَتَعَلَّمُونَ مِنْهُمَ مَا يُفَرِّقُونَ بِهِ بَيْنَ الْمَرْءِ وَزَوْجِهِ. And yet they learn from them, from Harut and Marut, what might cause division between a man and his wife. وَمَا هُمْ بِضَرِّينَ بِهِ مِنْ أَحَدٍ إِلَّا بِإِذْنِ اللَّهِ. And they cannot cause any harm to anyone except by the permission of Allah. So they don't harm. They don't harm at all. وَيَتَعَلَّمُونَ مَا يَضُرُّهُمَ لَا يَنْفَعُونَ. And they learn what hurts them, the magicians. So this is what we have tonight. Inshallah, Rabbil Alameen, next week, we'll talk about the ayah 31 to 33 from Surah Sad about the horses. Did Sulaiman prepare horses over the remembrance of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And inshallah, next week after, as we mentioned, we'll talk about the fitna as mentioned in the ayah 34. سبحانك اللهم وبحمدك لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك اللهم ونتوب إليك اللهم اجعل اجتماعنا هذا اجتماعا معصوما واجعل تفرقنا بعده تفرقا مرحوما ولا تدع فينا ولا بيننا شقيا ولا محروما والعصر إن الإنسان لفي خسر إلا الذين آمنوا وعملوا الصالحات وتواصوا بالحق وتواصوا بالصبر والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.